this is gonna be mad awkward since I haven't actually done this in a while, but what's up guys? I finally decided to come out of isolation and actually record something while I'm in between parts with uploading Danganronpa. Since I have finished the class trial, I just need to render and actually upload. But we're not talking about that. I got some sort of, I guess, motivation to do something like this, because I was roaming around YouTube and I saw a severe lack of helpful, I guess, tutorials on how to play Bullet. There's tons of shit on Dustloop, but I'm a more visual type of guy, like actually seeing somebody do it, and I don't see that many, well, at least American Bullet players share the tech. And from what I've been told, and what I personally think, I'm not that bad at playing this character. Maybe I'm bad at playing this game, but I'm not bad at playing this character. So I decided to help out the community that I've been a part of since, whenever I uploaded the first Persona 4 Arena Scrub Adventure thing. So I decided to give back and give a little insight of how to play this character, and for people to see how I finally operate as a fighting game player, let people know how I work while playing fighting games. But this is actually going to be mad awkward, because I've never actually commentated over my own matches before. I would always talk shit to my friends while playing, but I've never actually sat down and was like, yeah, I should be doing this. Yeah, this guy's doing this. I normally just sit down and stare angrily at my TV, because it's that serious to play fighting games. So, yeah. But I'm not going to bore you guys with any more talk. I'm just going to wait for my match to come, and then we'll get started. Always give people a chance. If it lags, leave. If it doesn't, continue playing. I don't think I said this before, but I actually really don't like fuck. I actually don't like playing anybody or fighting against anybody in this game. Like, not a single matchup I enjoy doing. The only reason why I play this game like this is because I really enjoy playing Bullet. So, yeah. What the? Whoa. This guy might be godlike if he has almost as many matches as me. But here comes the bane of everybody's existence when it comes to playing this game on Netplay. And this guy likes to skip the intro, so this is gonna be fun. Ragna is, I would say, one of Bullet's worst matchups, because he can do anything, you know? Oh my god. Let's see if he knows what he's doing. I guess not. But how I approach this matchup is that this button right here, that button with the fucking, where she extended her leg, that's probably one of her best buttons. No, not probably. It is her best button. But for that matchup, Ragna's really like to use his 5B a lot, and Bullet's 2B goes under his 5B. So you can stop their main approach by just doing that. Oh shit. That side move is plus as fuck, so oh shit. This guy's real. This guy's real. Not real enough though. What I like to do on their wake ups. Bullet can safe jump from her JC, this move right here. So on Ragna's, well, anybody with the DP's wake up, I like to do that a lot. So, you know, they can feel dumb. And I can get a free punish. But this guy doesn't like to DP, huh? That was smart. He's about to kill him. Like, he's about to kill me. That was nice, because I was about to kill him if he didn't do it. I thought he was going to be gone to Hades. But, GG's. Or GG. He did what he needed to do. 3C? You want to do her 236A on people's wake up, because it can, you know, cause them to do that. Oh, I can't believe I fucked that up. But it basically makes them block, and people in Blaze Blue don't like to block, so. Is it over? No, it's not over. Did I kill him? Damn. That sucks. That sucks. GG, sir. It was a bit laggy, but. But if you don't already own this game, you will know that everybody on Netplay plays this character, and it's at first it got really really annoying because all you fight are Ragna and Jhin, but after a while you kind of know how all of them play. Ragna kind of has the Minazuki problem. Once you fight, what, two or three of them, you basically know how all of them play. All of them go for Netplay gimmicks. All of them gets dumb damage every time they touch you. So, yeah. But I don't think I really did a good job of explaining what to do in that matchup. 2B is your best friend in this matchup. What else? Using her safe jump on their wake up is very, very good. And throwing in 3C every once in a while is pretty damn good as well. But when he does that scythe move in the air, you can't really press a button unless you DP. But, oh shit, that was nice. And for some reason that move is plus. I am fucking that up. Seems like getting hit by that though. Oh, he didn't press a button. Press a button there though. He was just mashing 5A right there. Why can I not block that? Why can I not block this? I tried to grab him. Am I dead? I'm not dead. Why do I keep trying to challenge that move? Oh my god. What you can do to that move is that you can grab him out of it and anti-air him. But as you can see, I suck at doing that. If you charge up her 5C, a little punch, I should have safe jumped right there. But we got DPs too. Ooh, whoops. No. With this, you should be dead. And that's why you should safe jump with Bullet, because you get 6K. You didn't last long. This guy likes just pressing buttons, huh? Let's see if he learned his lesson. Nope. Nope. Damn it, I was gonna bait his burst so hard. I don't think you can beta burst without 50 meter when you do her. That was nice. That was nice. He disrespected the fuck out of me. Okay, you need to stop jumping. Are you serious? Oh! Oh no! He should be dead. He should be dead. No. If I would have lost that. If I would have lost that. GG, sir. I was kind of bullshitting around at the end of that. This is a problem, a really big problem that I have. I get cocky really, really bad. And so with shit like that, I don't really worry. But, yeah, I don't like, I don't want to fight you again, so. Thanks for the games. called? Let's see. What else can I advise you? Wow, my controller. Well, honestly, what I was doing in that matchup wasn't really bad, per se. I was safe jumping a lot of his DPs, is what you want to do against characters like Ragna, Jhin, who else has an abusable DP. I can't remember most of the cast right now, damn. Kagura. Who is this guy? Why is he just looking at me? Oh, some guy that I'm not gonna fight. Who else do you want to safe jump? I guess Rachel, Tsubaki, Izayoi. If you Bullet has the tools to fuck them up, as you saw with me fighting Ragnar. So yeah, that's the main thing you want to do in that matchup on his wake up. If you feel like that he's not gonna respect you, or you feel like a DP's just coming, that's a lot of what I do as a player. You have to anticipate what your opponent's going to do. You can't just do stuff and wonder why it's not working, you know? You got to anticipate what they're going to do. Why am I getting hit by this? I'll tell you guys right now, I hate getting hit by DPs because it's like, you know, I could have baited that, but I decided to press buttons. Unless they're doing it in, like, the middle of my block string or something when I'm doing something unsafe, then I understand that. But on their wake-up, I hate getting hit by wake-up DPs because you can always do something about it. But, yeah. Okay, so I apologize if there's like a random jump cut in the video. Apparently, I did not know that even if the screen turns black, on the capture preview of the, Arcsoft showbiz, whatever, it's still recording. I thought that if it turned black, it stopped recording, so I was freaking out. But apparently, I don't know my own. After how many years have I had this thing? 2 years? I don't know my own capture card, so learn something new every day. But I actually fought some oh shit. Okay. I actually fought some pink rank Noel player that I should have recorded the matches for, but I didn't because I thought my PVR was acting up. But I had some pretty interesting matches with Noelle. I don't think that matchup is in her favor one bit. It seems that Noelle really struggles in that matchup, and I honestly feel bad. Ooh, a Hazma player. I fought this guy before. I forgot if he was good or not, though. We're about to find out. I remember when this game first came out, everybody regarded Hazma as like the best character in the game. I honestly don't know. I believe that he's top tier for sure, but I don't think he's the best character in the game. Actually, no, it was Nu, then Hazma, Jhin. Ragna and Jhin were the best characters in the game. That's what the first tier list was like. But now it then became Hazma, then Nu. I think Jhin is the best character in this game, if I'm correct. But whatever, fighting Hazma. Now, wow, what is this guy doing? He is just pressing buttons. Nice. What the fuck is this guy doing? Okay. He wants to press buttons, I'll press buttons. That was the wrong combo. Is he about to do it? Yeah, should've known. That's actually not a legit reversal. As you saw, I hit him right out of it. There's no invincibility on that move, so. He never really had a reversal in CPEX, so I don't know why everybody was. Wow, he got his burst back? He did burst like that earlier. So. I'll just wait for him. There you go. I can't really do like much good commentary for you guys when I don't like when it comes to players like this. I just don't know what to say. I think that these are the most dangerous players because it's like they don't give a fuck of what they push, you know, and they make you play pretty much their game. which is not what you want. You want to control the match like this. Okay. Oh shit. I'm just pressing buttons. Whoops. Stop. Whoa, what the fuck was that? I never saw that move before. I think that was his counter, maybe? Maybe that was his counter. Maybe. That was finish his guy off. And drop combo. Stop. People really need to wash their feet when it comes to that. That's like the go-to mix-up when somebody blocks the Jumbo 5D. Nice. That was very nice. I wasn't even paying attention to his meter. But he's supposed to get like mad damage from that. That's what I'd be told. I wouldn't know, because I don't face too many Hosmer players. Aww, I was gonna Astro him! I didn't do the command right. Damn. I thought I did it correctly. Guess not. But, yeah, when it comes to, no matter what fighting game you play, when it comes to players like this, the ones that just don't give a fuck and just push anything, I find those to be the most dangerous. Other than, you know, really good players. Well, he just went and done me. Because it's like, say, how should I give a good example of this? Like what he was doing. He was just pushing all kinds of buttons, just mashing 5A, doing, just being Spider-Man. Say if he had like a raging lion from Narugami. Say if he just kept doing that and over and over again and just doing really unsafe shit. It's like, it starts to get to you, and then you end up playing bad, and it's like, I'll tell you guys this. The one way to get me salty in any fighting game is for me to lose to somebody I have no business losing to. Not to, that sounds mad arrogant, I know, but it's like, you know your skill level, right? And you know how good you are. And then you can just tell when somebody is, like, not as good as you, but you stay losing to them. That makes me salty. That makes me really salty. But, yeah. I guess I'll see you guys in the next match. I'll see how this plays. Never judge a connection until you get to experience it. Plus, I need to fight Arakune anyway. I don't know about a one-bar Arakune, but I need to fight one. I don't really have too much matchup experience against this guy. So, what do I know about him, though? I know that this motherfucker can turn invisible, once he gets, he can get, like, what, 9k off of some dumbass curse combo? Oh, this guy's a real one. Oh, I'm about to get fucked up. Oh, Jesus. But, hey. Another little, like, helpful thing. I'll explain later. Round start 3C. Nice entire. Make sure you watch that, that curse meter. Because once that gets full, you're pretty much fucked. Like this. Just can't let him touch me. Whoa. Whoa. The fuck just happened? I just got peed on, didn't I? Jesus Christ. I just got peed on my own video. What? Let's rush him down. Or, what the fuck? He can do this? He can do this? What the fuck is going on? Oh shit. Damn. Get off. You look like he was about to bait my burst though. Now he does have a wake up reversal, so. Do you not like walking off? God damn. I hate playing this guy's neutral. Fuck. Nice. He can do that? I did not know he could do that. There you go. Fuck. Am I dead? He can send out a fake. I did not know that. The fuck is this? The fuck was that? I thought that shit was like unblockable. It was like, Alright. He did not respect me one bit. And I guess his 5A is faster than my 2B. This shit is fucking impossible. I hate fighting this nigga. Stop. That shit drained the piss. There we go. I should have saved jumping. I'm not bursting. Because he can. When he's in the middle of doing that, he's just. Oh shit, my phone's about to die. He's, blocking the entire time, so you can easily get your burst eaten. There's really no point in bursting that, but I almost got double perfected, I almost got astraled. Oh lord. But the connection wasn't that bad. I'll fight him again. But I fought maybe, what, 3 Arakunes? I did not know, like, he could create, like, a fake. That's so first, this guy can turn invisible, he can create a fake, he can pretty much float in the air, fly, and hey, he's one of the worst characters in the game though. I don't know what makes him bad. I honestly don't, because in the next game, in Central Fiction, he's one of the best characters in the game. But from what I've seen, he doesn't look that much different. He looks like Arakune. I don't know what makes him bad in this game. This tier list is wonky. And why is this man skipping the intro? I know that the connection was not bad, but come on, bro. Next time I'll just safe jump him and get hit. Nice. If you get hit by that, that's a lot of curse. Even if you block the bugs, you still get, you know, curse. Nice. Notice how he got curse from that too, and then he went invisible. Danny, this is Arakune! This is Arakune. God damn. I really don't know how to approach this guy. Okay. I am still getting hit by overheads. He's not falling for the 5D trick anymore. Nice. Tried to grab him. But it didn't even register that I pressed the button, so. This is where we're safe with him. And I didn't get a combo from that. I'm kind of mad. Well, I'm dead. Wow, that really happened to me. Oh, shit. Okay. I'm still cursed, though. And this motherfucker can turn invisible like it's no thing. This character is very, very stupid, ladies and gentlemen. But I don't fight this character, so I enjoy... Oh, well, I enjoy learning. I don't enjoy fighting him. Yeah, that's correct. I don't enjoy fighting any character in this game. I know I've already said that, but fuck every single last character in this game. I hate fighting Bullet too. So she's annoying. She's very annoying. But what do I feel like somebody's about to take my seat? Well, Lychee's better, and I guess he took pity on me. But I hate fighting this character too. She's very, very good. All these characters are very, very good. And that's why people said that I should like join tournaments. But it's like, I know this is a very big John, and that excuses literally get you nowhere. But it's like, this game and the character that I play, I'm literally terrified of fighting everybody. So no matter what opponent I'm fighting, I feel like I'm just going to lose. Fuck. Since you don't have your staff, you can't DP. Well, now you can. I didn't anticipate that was your smash. Fuck. Nice. That wasn't safe. Me pushing buttons isn't safe. But cross that man up. He should be dead. Yeah, he's dead. I don't think he knows. Maybe he does know what he's doing with Lychee. But I really wanted to fight his Arukune. Whatever. We blocked those. We blocked those. Aw, I didn't combo. Sad life. Fucking kidding me. Nice. He's not respecting me. I'm good. Which is what you shouldn't do. Okay, let's stop getting hit by that. This is where we safe, John. Wow, that's safe. If I touch him, he's dead. Well, I'm dead anyway, so. I don't know if he knew. But... Nice. Well, that's good. That's good. That was a good round because I made him get rid of his burst. So he can't, you know, burst. So, let's start DC. That was supposed to be DP. I'm gonna try to safe jump here. So he hasn't respected me at all. Or he can just get hit. Fine by me. That was a good fight. That was a good fight. Lychee, she basically controls, just like Arukune, she basically controls how neutral goes. He was just pressing buttons just because, well, I mean, Lychee can do that, don't get me wrong, but he was just pushing all types of buttons, and it's, no, no, it's not good. My character may be weak, but she punishes you for pushing buttons all willy-nilly. So, hopefully he goes back to Arakuna. I want to fight as Arakuna anymore than this Lychee. Okay. Change up the music. Maybe it's the Arakune in him, or maybe he just doesn't like to block, because with Arakune, he got hit by Wake Up 2B, like, or on his Wake Up 2B, like, three different times, and I could have killed him, but it's like, with Lychee, he just DP, so you gotta pick up on stuff like that when you fight different players. You gotta know what their habits are and how to stop it. It's called adapting. I was gonna say, I was surprised he didn't burst. I knew that overhead was coming, but didn't do nothing about it. That's actually very dangerous, and I wouldn't suggest doing that, but that worked. Stop. Thought I would recover. Hey. What the fuck? My anti-air DP didn't come out. My anti-air command grab, I should say. Nice. He's dead. He was dead, but yeah, he's dead. I hate it when I drop that combo, because in instances like that, I need to do that combo so I can win. That was a mistake. That's why he didn't DP right there. I was gonna say, I've never seen a Lychee air combo before. Stop. One more confirm and he's dead. Well, I don't know if I resetted him right there, or I don't know. That was a combo. That should have worked. Big booby lady versus other big booby lady. Alright, let's see now if he'll go to whatchamacallit. Arakune. I need the matchup experience. Thank you. You know I need Lychee EXP too. I don't need it as much as Arakune. But I guess he got tired of losing. I mean, I don't mind when people do that, because I do it to other people, because it's like, you want to give the other person a chance to win, right? Because it's not, how should I explain this? When you're fighting somebody, it's like, you want it to be, you know, fair, unless you really do not like the person, or you're a scrub killer, and you enjoy beating up on scrubs, but it's like, I can't do that work. That was a mistake. Oh, that's a mistake. For the record, I did not mean to do that. It just happened. Fuck. And he gets cursed. He's dead. He should be dead. There we go. Finally got my first round. And I can't tell you what I did, because I was just, well, he doesn't like to block, so picked up on that. That was an accident. Try to American reset him right there. He had a burst. Damn, I did not see that. Watch your feet. He should be. That should have been death. I am so mad I dropped that combo. He should be dead right now. Did he just reset me? Get off me. You're not supposed to attack me, I guess. I can't kill him off of this. Oh, this is annoying because he won, didn't he? No, I won. GG's. GG's. Do we want and done as Arukune now? Do we want and done as Arukune? Nah, I'll get on with it. That was fun, though. That was real fun. But that combo that I got from the that 6A starter, he would have been dead. Because I would have wasted my my burst overdrive and everything to kill him. What I can just tell you guys with this matchup, always do the Oki setup with the 236A. Unless he has 50 meter, because then he can just reversal super you. And as long as you keep him pinned down, I guess that's why people consider him to be so low. Because he doesn't have that. He only has that one super. And it's kind of easy to know when he's going to do it. So I guess that's why. It's really easy to, because once you get started on him, I guess, it's hard for him to escape. I guess that's why he's considered low tier. I don't know. Nice. No. He just does not like to get hit, does he? Oh, I'm cursing because I went into the poison power. As soon as you get a confirmed, just block. As soon as you're done with your combo, just block. God damn. This motherfucker. I'm gonna save jump after this because he has freaking me. Oh my god, why? I'm so mad. If I would have lost that, that was supposed to be super. I don't know why I was doing that. You know, I probably could have. I shouldn't have been right there anyway. That's plus one, so I'm surprised I got that. He's dead. He should be dead. Fuck that. I should have won. But you see, I won't say that I adapted, because there's no way I adapted. I just pushed more buttons, to be honest with you. Him in particular, what I notice is that he just doesn't like to block. And when he gets put into that situation, when he does have to block, he either immediately bursts or just pushes buttons. But I think I'm done fighting you. Where is it? Thanks for the games. See if we can find somebody else. You see, the greatest strength that you can have as a fighting game player is just to adapt. Like, know what your opponent is doing and then find a way to, you know, counteract that. That's kind of how I play, and that's how I know three other people in the Salty Suite that does that. Three other people. And they're really good because of that. Not to say that the rest aren't good. I believe from what I've played on Netplay, in any game I've played, I always considered, you know, the Salty Suite to be, you know, of high caliber. I put my friends, like, really, really high up on the people that I think are good, no matter what game we play, because, you know, they're my friends. But if you can adapt, then you can pretty much tackle any challenge. But there's also limitations like matchups, your character, and all the other stuff. But I don't know. I don't use that as an excuse anymore because, from what I think, how should I put this? If you guys remember my original Persona 4 Let's Play, I complained and complained about how Bullet was awful, awful this, awful that, in the original BBCP, and she was. She honestly was. I don't see how anybody could have played that version of Bullet. She felt so incomplete that it hurt. But I pick up this game because on a whim I picked up this game. Found out my character got buffed, and now look at me. I'm playing people like this and winning and learning more about this game and learning my character. It's all good, all fun stuff. Actually, Bullet is the low. I played Chie, Arena Ultimax, Aurea. I did play Elfell. Played Elfell in Guilty Gear. What other fighting? I played How Wrong. Played Ken in Street Fighter. Bullet is literally the lowest tier character that I've ever played in a fighting game, and arguably she's the one next to Chie, of course, that I put the most time into. But unlike with Chie, I found out all this stuff that I could do with Bullet by myself, pretty much. Of course, Dust Loop helped and all that other good shit, and I watched a few videos that was from the JP players. But most of the combos that I do, I didn't look, well, except for the level 2 heat up combo that I waste and then I immediately get right back. I found that in the video. All the rest of the combos I've done myself. I've not looked up any other Bullet videos, and that's why I'm doing this right now, so I can spread my knowledge about this character and all the other good shit. But I'll just wait for my next fight.